Hello, welcome to another segment of how to use CorelDRAW. Okay, today we are going to talk about how to curve edges of rectangle or square, how to manipulate shapes, how to convert text to curve, which is also shape. When you convert your text to curve, it means you've turned the text from being a font to becoming a shape. How to draw lines, how to make shapes using shape tool. We are going to make use of shape tool majorly throughout this session. Okay, so we want to learn first how to curve the edges, meaning how to curve the radius of our square. To do this, method one, select your shape. Already, if you just launch your program, you can change from millimeters to inches. You can change your unit of measurement to inches. That's what I'm working with. So click on shape tool, point on the corner of your shape, ensure you are on the node selected here. Okay, so click and drag to your desired radius. The first side of the shape has been changed, has been curved, like you see. So just do it, curve it to the point you want and this. Method 2, I'm taking it back to the curve vertex, the sharp vertex, I'm taking it back. Okay, so method 2, select your shape, come over to your standard, your property toolbar, and then change corner radius to the desired figure that you want. For example, I enter 20, you can see the result. So let's say 5. Around the figures to get the desired radius curve. That's how to curve the edge of your rectangle or square method 2. So to change it back to the previous, you can just enter 0 figure here, and all the 4 corners are back to how you were before. There's another thing you want to learn about curving your shape. For instance, I might want only one side of the shape to be curved, or the upper left corner and the bottom right corner of the shape to be curved, and then leaving the other ones the way they are. To do that, using the shape tool, meaning your mouse and your keyboard together, click on shape tool, go to where you want to curve, hold down control key, and you can curve only this corner. You can also come to the next one, hold down control key and curve. So I'm trying to make sure I give it the same. See, 0.591 and 0.591 here. So I've been able to curve the left upper corner and the right bottom corner of the shape. You can also do this by entering the figures on the property bar, but before you do that, you need to uncheck. Together. You need to unlock this key. If it's locked, it means that if you enter any figure here, this figure is going to be applied all through the four corners. If you observe, this one has extended a little bit more than the previous, and this just added the new value. This new value has been doubled to this. So I'm going to just have reduced everything back to zero. So I unlock this, enter my radius value. By entering here, by enter the value here, it means in this right upper corner that the changes will take effect. You can see that. So each of these boxes represent the four corners of the shape. So enter the value here. So that's it. This is how to achieve this using the property bar. When you click on your shape, the property bar comes out. You unlock this key so that you can add values differently, individually. But if you want your values to be applied to all the corners, so you just go ahead and lock the padlock back, lock it back, and enter your value. The value you want. So I'm going to just enter 0 to turn everything back to normal. And here too. Alright. How to manipulate shapes? We've done one. I'm moving this shape over here. Going to duplicate this, right click, drag, click, copy here. So I'm going to select this shape together with this, and I want it to become one. So after doing this, click weld. They are now together. The previous one was like this. If I'm adding a few colors, I have to add them individually. If I then giving the same few color to the two shapes, and this is how I want it to be, it means I am going to have to add them individually and probably remove outline from both of them so they can look uniform. But to save myself that stress, I will just have to mesh the two shapes together by welding it. Just select your shape, click weld. Weld combines objects into a single curved object with a single fill and outline. As you can see, it's now one. If I have already applied few color to one of these shapes before selecting this together and weld, see the color is gone until I have to reapply it and everything takes the same color. So we've been able to transform our rectangle to a different shape. How to convert text? For instance, let's say blue, my mind. So I want to change the typeface of this text, that is the text type. Just click on it, make sure the text is selected, go to your font list and choose a typeface. Okay, let's say I want to work with geometric, or let's use impact. Simply type in the font name, impact. Look at it, it's out, or you just press enter after typing it. Okay, so as this shape is, I cannot manipulate it by maybe changing the style of the text, like if I might think of dragging this L, dragging the end of it up a little bit, or just twisting it around, just playing around, trying to be creative with the text. I won't be able to do that until I transform this from being a typeface to a cuff. That means I convert this text from being a text to being a shape. That is when I can use my shape tool to actually play around it by affecting the change or adjustment I need on the notes. These are the notes. This is where you are able to click to make adjustment. You can also call it handle. Okay, so let's do this. First, I'm going to duplicate this. Just keep this one aside. Click on the text. Go to Object. Click Convert to Curves. The shortcut is Ctrl Q. You can also right click on the text and click Convert to Curves. At this point, anything I want to do, anyhow I want to adjust this text, I have to bring out my shape tool. You can see many of the handles are active, but I cannot do anything until I select on a particular handle. Then I can adjust the text. So I will just undo this. Okay, let's say I'm coming to Y. Coming to Y, I drag this out. Letter Y, I'm making it longer. And then you can select multiple notes by simply dragging with your shape tool across the handles, as you can see. So I can be able to do any adjustment that I want with this. So this is how to convert text to curve. Another reason why you should convert your text to curve is so that when you take your artwork to another system that may not have your same font style, your artwork will not change. You won't have to lose your text value. So for instance, if you are doing a job, you want to go and print it outside, you have to ensure you convert your text to shape. By the time you take it outside, it will remain the way it is. For instance, if I take this job to another system that perhaps doesn't have impact, of course impact is a predefined form that comes with all operating systems. But let's say I'm using a special font that is not installed on another system. So by the time I will take this to that system, opening the file, I'm going to lose this font style. And I will have to, you know, try to see how I can fix that. So to avoid all that drama, it's better to always convert your text to curve, even if you don't want to make any adjustment like what we just did here. You can just convert it to curve, save your work, and proceed. So, how to draw lines? The previous one we just did now is how to convert text to curve or shape. So, how to draw lines? To draw lines, let's say I need a line between. Let's work with this. So let's say I need a line between mine. Just go to your freehand. There are several ways to do this. If you want to use your freehand tool, what you need to do is click on it or press F5, which is the shortcut. Point on where you want to draw the line, where you want the line to start. Click. And then move your mouse to where you want the line to stop. Hold down Shift key, Prince. You can also dance with the White Dragon. I'm repeating this step again. Go to your free hand tool and click. Go to where you want the line to start. Click. Go dance it. Move your mouse pointer to where you want the line to end. Then click. Why still holding down the shape? Okay, so after then, you can remember from our previous class, we were changing the line thickness. And you even work on the style. So you just go ahead and do what you want to do with your line. That's how to draw the line. Not to duplicate it. You can get already discussed on how to duplicate the line. You can just copy and paste. Control C, Control V. Then take your arrow key to drag the line. Or right click and drag the line by holding down your Control and Shift key to maintain the proper positioning. And horizontal position. Then release your mouse. Release the shift key now. Release your mouse and copy it. Alright. The next one is how to make shapes. We've already done that. Want to draw a cube. We are working it, we are still on how to manipulate shape. So let's create a cube. I'm going to draw my square and probably enter the value there. I want to maintain the same distance up and top. So I'm just going to duplicate this shape again. Alright. So skew this up. Thank you. have to do that, I will bring in transparency to be part of this news, which is about where I want to go. Okay, so to apply transparency, just come to your toolbox and you say transparency tool. It's a partially review image areas underneath the object. So click on it. The live tool setting I've come out for transparent tool. So I'm applying it on the yellow box. What you need to do is you can just make adjustments. So I'm adding this transparency to the object. Now there's no object behind the yellow. That's why what we see is the white background. Let me just put an object here and send it behind. A command that allows you to send your object to the back of another object. Just go select the object, go to object, order, set to back of page. This sends it completely behind the page. So you can see the black trying to prevail because I have added transparency to the first shape. Okay, so at the start, I want to create another shape so that when you look through, it's completely a three-dimensional object. And the best way to do this, just duplicate this object in front, copy and paste, so it maintains the same position of the bottom here. So the next thing is, we have two of these right now, so we are working with one of it. We are going to send one of it behind, so it will stay beside the other side of the object, just like this. So click on shape tool. Always remember to curve your shape, come back to curve before using the shape tool. So drag this handle over here and then drag this right to the center. Let's send it behind the red box. Right click on the object, point on order, click on behind. So it brings out an arrow. You have to use this arrow to direct which object this yellow shape will go behind on. So point on the red, click behind. So I've sent it behind. Okay, we still have two more things to do. I'm going to create an interior part of this shape, so it lays across the bottom here. So what you need to do is right click on this, copy and paste. You can right click, copy, then that you use here to paste or just control B. Alright, with your shape tool again, I'm bringing that node over here, and I'm bringing this other node down here. So we'll send this one behind the blue. Right click, order. Let me just give it a different color. And remaining the back side. So you can just do the same thing. Right click on the new, copy, paste. Come over here. Bring this other note here. Again. Send this behind red. Send it again behind. You can change the color too, so you understand what you are doing. Using gray. So send it again behind you. Alright, so now let's enhance the yellow shape at the front, which is this one. Let's increase the transparency a bit. Just click on it. If you are unable to click on it directly, like you see, I'll try to click on it then. I didn't get it because other shapes are in front of it. So the best thing is select it this way, send it to front on the property bar, or just right click, point on the center here, right click, order. I don't want to stress myself trying to get access to this. So what I do, I just drag my matching selection tool across the shape. I ensure you don't allow it to cover the rest of the shape, just the one that you select. Then let me give it orange. The idea is when someone look at this object, you'll be able to see the inside of it. You can still do the same thing over here. So I'm able to give someone a see-through effect. You can apply the same effect to the top side. From the top, you can see how it goes around. Look from the left side and look from the right behind the inside of the box. You can see the object where the inside looks like. So you have to apply the add note, point on the line, ensure the point on the line when you change this to the curve shape for the foot. Then I can adjust it. So with that, it makes my dimension box to actually come out from the writing platform. How do I clear shape? Let's play around our rectangle. So same time, I'm going to show you how to make use of what is called gradient vector. Click on the ellipse view. like there's actually a rule around. After manipulation, select the second shape, then select the first one, hold down to click on the second one, that's how to select shapes, then click on trim. Trim will cut out the portion of this from this. Look at that. Then
moving
it over here. I could have just do everything inside this box. I want you to see it for yourself. Upside down or from the left to the right. So I will turn it upside down by going to, after selecting it, my property bias is active, so I click on mirror vertically. Okay, and then I click on mirror horizontally, flip the object from left to right. So I'm moving the object over here. How to manipulate shapes. I'm going to cough the button like this. I'm coughing both up and down the first side of the shape. I'm coughing. Apply gradient fill to this object. Meanwhile, I want to make it look a little bit realistic. So I'm adding this shape to the front. So apply gradient fill. You can use the shortcut by just pressing G on your keyboard. Press so select on the shape, press G. So you can see the tool have changed from just being a pointer to having a bucket on it. So what you do is you decide whether you want to fill from up down or from left to the right or right to the left. Whichever way, you can always adjust it. Let's say I'm cool with this. Yeah, to change the colors that is here already, double click on the color box. Each of these boxes contain the colors that you can adjust. So white is already active. Click on it. Come over to note color. Click and choose any color choice that you want. Repeat the same thing with this. And click. click your mouse pointer if you are okay. I don't need the outline, so remove it. So let's say this is what I actually wanted to achieve, and I've achieved it. I don't need all this here again.
Love is never where you're looking. See the rose on stony ground. You believe in what you're
feeling. So what remains is how to add shadows to your object or text. To add shadow, for instance, let's say I want to add shadow to this, but I'm not going to add shadow to black because shadow is also black. So I will change this font to a lighter color, then go to your toolbox, click on drop shadow to. Click and drag it across. Then you see how it is. Try to make it fit in. Just hold down Ctrl to right drag it so it fits in. And then you have button shadow. You can also drag this away to see the shadow being far from the text. So we are going to learn how to make proper use of this as we continue learning how to design. So, we've learned how to manipulate shapes, how to add transparency, how to add shadow, how to add gradient color to our object or text, and we've been able to create a cube box using rectangle tool and shape tool. So to make you remember how it all goes and go integrating the whole thing. Creating shed. So this is what we've been able to bring in together. Thank you for your time. We'll proceed on learning other things to start learning how to design cards, flyers, but you need to familiarize yourself with these basics so that when you enter the next class, be able to